In last lecture, we discussed amoeba in rhizopoda. Now, second example is entamoeba. It is found in vertebral and invertebral intestine. They have three important species: Entamoeba histolytica, Escherichia coli, and Entamoeba gingivalis. Found in invertebrate and vertebrate intestine. Three species: Entamoeba histolytica, Entamoeba coli, that is not Escherichia coli, and Entamoeba gingivalis. There are three common species of Entamoeba which are commonly found. So one by one we'll discuss these three species. So we'll start with Entamoeba histolytica. Entamoeba histolytica is a parasite in large intestine of human beings. Parasite in large intestine of human beings. Human body में, हमारी body में large intestine का common parasite है Entamoeba histolytica. And it causes amoeboid dysentery or amoebiosis. Causes amoebiosis or amoebic dysentery. Amoebiosis or amoebic dysentery is caused. Unlike many other parasites, it is monogenetic. It's only single host. This monogenetic or monogenic parasite. Adult is trophozoite. Adult form is called as trophozoite. And found in two forms, magma and minuta. Two forms hoti hai. It is found in two forms, magma and minuta. Magma and minuta. Magna is infective form and minuta is non-pathogenic. It is pathogenic and found in mucosa, submucosa. Found in mucosa, submucosa. And minuta is non-pathogenic and found in lumen of intestine. In lumen of intestine. So दो form है, pathogenic and non-pathogenic. Pathogenic form is magna, found in mucosa and submucosa, and non-pathogenic is minuta. In Entamoeba histolytica, the parasite reaches to other organs of the body. So अगर जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स की बात करें तो कॉन्ट्रेक्टाइल वैक्यूल्स आर एबसेंट. जबकि अमीबा में कॉन्ट्रेक्टाइल वैक्यूल्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं. जो ट्रोपोजोइट हैं उनमें बाइनरी फ्यूजन होता है. And minuta forms insist. Insistment occurs. और जो mature cyst है, mature cyst is known as quadrinucleate. Mature cyst is called quadrinucleate. Which develops from minuta. Quadrinucleate का मतलब ये हो गया कि इसमें क्या होंगे, चार न्यूक्लिया होंगे. Four nuclei are present. So four different nuclei are found here. So it is known as quadrinucleate cyst or mature cyst. And two chromatid bodies are clearly visible here. So four nuclei and two chromatid bodies. So this is the infective stage. It is infective stage. Infection occurs at this stage. This is infective stage. And infection occurs through contaminated food and water. Causes infection. So these are the, this is the pathology of Entamoeba histolytica. Life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica. The trophozoite, मैंने आपको बताया, adult stage is called trophozoite. So we'll start from trophozoite, adult stage. And this trophozoid stage, single nucleus is present. So, single nucleus. And in endoplasm, दिस साइटोप्लाज्म इज नोन एज एंडोप्लाज्म. इन एंडोप्लाज्म फूड वैक्यूल्स एंड इंजेस्टेड आरबीसीज आर प्रेजेंट. This is a food vacuole and this is tropozoid. Now this tropozoid undergoes binary fission. It undergoes binary fission or asexual reproduction to form cyst. A cyst wall or cyst is formed so protective covering known as cyst wall and certain vacuoles a nucleus and now chromatid body appears. These are chromatid bodies. So chromatid bodies appears, nucleus, and this is cyst. The cyst changes into binucleate cyst. Now nucleus undergoes division. And two nuclei are formed along with chromatid body. So two nuclei cyst, a binucleate cyst, binucleate cyst is formed. This binucleate cyst grow in size, nucleus divide one more time and it develops or it changes into quadrinucleate cyst. जो अभी थोड़ी देर पहले हमने डिस्कस किया था, quadrinucleate cyst is formed. Having four nuclei and number of chromatid bodies also gets doubled. Four nuclei and two chromatid bodies. This is known as quadrinucleate cyst. Quadrinucleate cyst, and it is the infective stage. Quadrinucleate stage is the cyst is the infective stage. Now it undergoes encystment so from cyst wall this type of division starts. So this is cyst wall and this process is known as encystment. And after encystment, after this division of cells, metacystic amoeba is formed. inside one cell a number of cells are present, and this is known as metacystic amoeba. Metacystic amoeba. And this metacystic amoeba forms amoebules. This wall ruptures and a large number of cells are released. And these cells are known as amoebule. And which changes into tropozoid. So this is the life cycle of a Entamoeba histolytica. This is life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica. Life cycle. Entamoeba histolytica. Simplified. Now second one is Entamoeba gingivalis. Entamoeba gingivalis. Entamoeba gingivalis. It is a parasite in human teeth. Parasite of human teeth. Human teeth parasite. Which causes pyorrhea or bleeding gums. Bleeding gums are caused due to Entamoeba gingivalis. Amoeba again is adult is again tropozoid, and this gingivalis adult form is called tropozoid. It feeds on WBCs. No cyst formation like histolytica, and direct infection occurs. Infection, direct infection like kissing, etc. So direct infection occurs with the infected person. And third one is Entamoeba coli. Third one is Entamoeba coli. It found in human colon. Found in human colon. Commensal parasite means does not cause any disease. Commensal parasite. No disease is caused. But हैवी इन्फेक्शन में कोज इंटेस्टाइनल ट्रबल्स, हैवी इन्फेक्शन में कोज इंटेस्टाइनल ट्रबल्स. सिस्ट हैज 8 न्यूक्लियाई बट फ्रॉम दोज 8 न्यूक्लियाई 4 अमीब्यूल आर प्रोड्यूस्ड. Nuclei are 8 in cyst, but 4 amoeboli are present. So these are different types of Entamoeba. Entamoeba histolytica, Entamoeba gingivalis, and Entamoeba coli. Two causes diseases in human beings, but third one is commensal parasite. Only heavy infection causes a minor trouble in intestine. Three more types of sarcodines: radiolarians, formiferans, and heliogens. So, first of all, radiolarians. रेडियोलेरियंस मराइन है, फ्री फ्लोटिंग है. मराइन फ्री फ्लोटिंग फॉर्म. सो इट गिव्स अ रेडिएटिंग स्ट्रक्चर. सिलेरियस सिलिका स्केलेटन है. Radiating structure, radiating structure. जो प्रोटोप्लाज्म है वो दो पार्ट में डिवाइड है. प्रोटोप्लाज्म इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स और टू एरियाज, एक्स्ट्रा कैप्सुलर एंड इंट्रा कैप्सुलर. इंट्राकैप्सुलर रीजन एंड एक्स्ट्रा कैप्सुलर रीजन. इंट्रा एंड एक्स्ट्रा कैप्सुलर. सो प्रोटोप्लाज्म तो दो पार्ट में डिवाइड हो गया, इंट्रा एंड एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर पार्ट्स. फ्रॉम दिस एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर एक्स्ट्रा कैप्सुलर पार्ट सूडोपोडिया डेवलप्स. Pseudopodia develops from this extracapsular part for locomotion. And pseudopodia are filopodia type. Filopodia develops. If we make the diagram, there is a centralized canal or part, and from the centralized part radiating structures arises in different directions. And it forms another covering. And these radiating structures emerges in all the directions. So this is the central sheath. And this is extracapsular region. which give rise to pseudopodia. And the pseudopodia are exopodia, sorry, filiopodia. Now this intracapsular region, contains nuclei, vacuoles and reserve food. It contains nuclei, vacuole and reserve food. And it is the reproductive part. It represents reproductive part. So reproduction by, this is reproductive part or reproductive area, and reproduction occurs through binary fission and swarm cells, swarm pores. Binary fission plus swarm pores. These radiolarians, they get deposited because they have silica skeleton, so it does not, they do not decompose even after death. So they decompose at the bottom of aquatic systems like diatomaceous earth, and that is known as, the deposition is known as radiolarian ooze. So deposits of radiolarian skeleton, used as rubbing material, abrasive and filtering agent. So these are radiolarians. Now second group is foraminiferans. Radiolarians के बाद जो दूसरा ग्रुप है, that is foraminiferans. They are bottom dwellers. They can be both marine as well as freshwater organisms having, वहां पे silica की skeleton था, यहाँ पे calcium का skeleton होता है, and perforations are found. इसके एग्जाम्पल्स हम अगर देखें, एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ रेडियोलेरियंस इज कोलोजम, सो दीज आर बॉटम ड्वेलर्स, मराइन और फ्रेश वाटर, कैल्शियम स्केलेटन, परफोरेशंस आर फाउंड. एंड यहां पे भी जो प्रोटोप्लाज्म है, प्रोटोप्लाज्म डेवलप्स सुडोपोडिया, प्रोटोप्लाज्म बाहर निकल जाता है उसे सुडोपोडिया की फॉर्मेशन होती है। सुडोपोडिया यहां पे भी प्रेजेंट है, विच आर रेटिकुलोपोडिया, सुडोपोडिया आर रेटिकुलोपोडिया टाइप। डायग्रामेटिकली इट इज वेरी सिंपल एज कंपेयर टू रेडियोलेरियंस। So these perforations are present. Which represents reticulopodia. This is the outermost shell. And in the shell, pores are present. So this is foraminifera. In foraminiferans, reproduction same binary fission, reproduction by binary as well as multiple fission. Binary and multiple fission and flagellated gametes, Zeldzian syngamy occurs because gametes are flagellated. So syngamy occurs. Example is ग्लोबिजेरिना, कॉमन एग्जाम्पल है इसका ग्लोबिजेरिना। और एक जो इसका जो कलेक्शन है लाइक रेडियोलेरियंस कैल्सेरियस फॉर्मिनिफेरंस, उनके जो शेल है वो कलेक्ट हो जाते हैं बॉटम पे एंड दैट इज नोन एज फॉर्मिनिफेरन ऊज। और ये टाइम के साथ साथ लाइमस्टोन रॉक्स में चेंज हो जाते हैं। कैल्केरियस स्केलेटन डिपॉजिट एट बॉटम एंड इट इज नोन एज फॉर्मिनिफेरन ऊज। Foraminiferan ooze and with time it changes into limestone rocks, changes to limestone rocks, and limestone is used as building material. और जो इजिप्टियन पिरामिड्स हैं दे आर फॉर्म्ड ऑफ दिस लाइमस्टोन रॉक्स। ग्लोबिजेरिना इज द कॉमन एग्जांपल एंड द थर्ड वन और थर्ड ग्रुप इज हेलियोजोन्स। थर्ड ग्रुप इज हेलियोजोन्स। द They are spherical in shape. They are spherical in shape. Pseudopodia present. Pseudopodia are of exopodia type. And they radiate in all direction. Radiate in all directions. Pseudopodia radiate in all directions. इसमें जो कवरिंग है, जो शेल है, वो सिलिका का बना हो सकता है या स्पाइनस हो सकता है. शेल कैन बी स्पाइनस और सिलिका, बट इट कैन बी नेकेड आल्सो. एलियोजोन्स कैन बी नेकेड आल्सो. तो शेल हमेशा प्रेजेंट नहीं होता. एंड शेल एस हेलियोजोन का एग्जांपल है एक्टिनोफायरस. एक्टिनोफायरस